Miscanthus can be harvested with traditional silage topping equipment. You can see it's got small stems relative to corn, so roughly the size of my pinky finger. The stems get rather tough as the season goes on, but it's no match for silage topping equipment, and it can be harvested easily with conventional combines or hay binds. The timing of Miscanthus harvesting is also quite interesting. You can see right now that it's brown, and this is a very important attribute of the Miscanthus life cycle. You want to harvest after the plant has senesced. This means that it has sent all of its nitrogen and a lot of its sugar back below ground, back to those rhizomes. And that essentially means you have next year's fertilizer stored below ground. That makes the crop very low input when you manage it on an annual basis. It also means that this material has very little nitrogen left in it. That's a good thing from a fuel perspective. When we burn a crop or use a crop for fuel, that nitrogen in the crop is actually a pollutant, a contaminant. It's bad for the process of conversion to fuel, and it's also bad for the environment once the fuel is converted. So we really like to harvest Miscanthus after it's dried down for the season. And that happens anytime between November in the Midwest, and then the crop will start to grow again around March or April. So the harvest window is any time between that, between November and the initiation of growth again in the spring. This is a very long harvest window, and that's also a nice attribute of the crop. It means that we can harvest it when we're ready to. We don't have to store it. It will store in the field. Miscanthus doesn't lodge, even under icefall conditions. One of the major considerations is just whether or not there's snow on the field. So as long as you can find a time during the winter when it's cold and dry and there's not snow in the crop, harvest whenever needed.